Alright, everybody, we're just gonna jump. Oh, apparently there's skags about. Where are my hands? We're just gonna jump right into it. No fancy intro today. Just, just jumping right into the Borderlands. The game, I guess. This is the third episode of our Borderlands playthrough, and I don't know how far I'm gonna go. Probably just to the end of the Firestone portion. What am I looking for? I'm looking for what quest I want. Get a little blood on the tires. Let's get a little blood on the tires. Squish. Squish. And once more, if you missed it last time. Gonna go. Actually, did I miss it? I did. I missed talking to Shep. Ugh, that's what happens when you do this piecemeal. I used to go through basically Firestone all in one sitting. Hey there, Shep. Grab a bunch of quests, and we'll look again. So, we've got... One of these should say... Mission quest, should it not? Maybe not. I mean, that's the mission quest, but... There's an order I usually do this in. They're all sort of in the same-ish area, so I tend to run through these quests fairly quickly. Assuming I can... Good grief. Assuming I can actually steer. There'll be a big nasty sack coming here soon. No. Thank you. Let's see. Ooh, I got a skill point. Let me spend that. Quite normal. Just turning axes, buzz axes from all the way over there. Which is funny because I remember quite late in the last session being like, this is a great sniper rifle. Wasting time trying to snipe with an inaccurate numeral B. Nice. Another quest ready to turn in. Hidden journal. Oh yeah, we're about to meet Patricia Tanis. Doll scientific advisor. Funny, I usually come in here from the roof. Instead of a key, you found a note. Alright, well. I'd still try to get up on the roof.
Oh!
Right, I can't, like, grab onto ledges to pull myself up. I have to be... Has to be a straight jump. So where do I get up from here? This side? Yes. Your SMG? Sure. Why not?
This is the 76th day. I was woken up, hoping I was having a reoccurring nightmare.
The 76th day, eh? Looks like right in the
middle. More than 36 hours earlier today, relocating our campsite closer to our dig site, only to be ambushed by local wildlife. Hungry coming out of hibernation. Half of my staff was eaten alive or killed by skags. I survived by hiding under a colleague of mine who was being devoured on top of me. His name was Carl. My emotions are deadened, and I grieve for none of them. In point of fact, the only emotion I felt was that of joy. I felt joy because his chair was always more comfortable than mine. I took his chair, and then I noticed the emissive glow on the watch.
Another notch in my rifle.
Yeah, tennis is not right in the head. Although, I feel like what they did with the character is a little over the top. I feel like she's lost a lot of her pathos in no longer being traumatized, untraumatized normal person, and instead being crazy from the get-go.
Day 119. I sat in the shower in tears for just under an hour. This is interesting, considering we haven't had water for days. I equate my ever-decreasing sanity with that of the population of my dig site. With the investigation of the symbols and glowing patterns of the site, we finally unearthed arguably certifiable proof of the existence of alien life having been here on Pandora. But this celebration was lonely, as I only have two colleagues left. And I'm not too fond of the fat girl, Shimei. I've been told that scientific discovery requires sacrifice, but I never understood what they meant until now.
I think Bonehead may be back. Looks like Bonehead's back. I haven't died yet, which is kind of neat, honestly. But if I try to go up against Bonehead again like this, I feel like that's not going to stay the case. Especially if I blow up my own grenades in my face. Skags abound. Thank you.
Janice, Dahl Scientific Advisor, Day 1 on planet Pandora. I have been assigned to this sector by my superiors to find evidence of abandoned alien technology similar to that found by our competitor, the Atlas Company, in the ruins on Prometheus. Technology that many believe made them the superpower they are now. This kind of find seems astronomically improbable on a rock like this, but my benefactors believe in it enough to waste my considerable talents. I've only been here for 3 hours, and I already believe this planet will be the death of me. Scientists do not chase myths and legends.
I don't know. A planet named Pandora? It's like you're asking for trouble. Probably not worth it. Damn it. If you long hold the pickup button, you'll equip the weapon instead of just picking it up. Alright, let's give this one a shot.
Day 43 on Pandora. At least I believe it to be the 43rd day I've been here. The moonlight cycles are difficult to get used to. The planet rotation day is over 90 hours long. The people that inhabit this salted dust ball are as ignorant as I see this galaxy. When I attach scientific inquiry to something like the Vault, I'm greeted with silly nursery rhymes and slack-jawed soliloquy about a man who knew a man who knew a man. They drift off into a stupor where I half imagine they're drunk or brain damaged. And I...
just one more hidden journal left?
Oh, unaware of my continued presence. If I believed in hell, I would contemplate how it compared to Pandora. Ironically, such a belief would align me with these Neanderthals.
Yeah, she's not very nice. Ooh. Well, that certainly worked. Juicy chunks. Where's the last one? Oh, I know where the last one is. Driving around like a crazy person. Where the heck am I? I went the wrong way. Can you tell I'm kind of tired? I did not sleep well. And sleep was a long time ago. I've been working overnights at a new job since my old job, canned me for trying to unionize, basically. Which is illegal, but of course they called it a restructuring, so I can't say boo. There we are. Sorry, I will listen to your diatribe. I just want to Ooh, the shot crystal harvest is no longer impossible. Let's do that.
This wasn't me. As she was choking and coughing and dying, I tried to enjoy the interaction, which I imagined to be a conversation, as I knew it was the last I would have for a while. I finally got around to smothering her so that I could continue my research. I could tell that she regretted the decision. The Skags have been waiting for this meal for a while. They will not go hungry tonight.
I missed, but now, of course, it's going to come straight at me, so it'll make it very difficult to miss. Alright. Before we go any further, let's check our guns. Let's see. Sort. Page down to sort. I'm also operating with a weird computer, so... stay with that repeater. I think that newer bone shredder is worth looking into. And... I think I'll hold on to this one for now. I have any other options for shields. That one is quite a bit better. I think it's time to not hold on to my healing shield just because it's a healing shield. Alright. Wait. What? I thought I equipped this.
The latest and greatest in high powered weaponry and gear sold right here for your convenience.
Just sell it. These ones are highly deadly, but they have a neat little weak spot that if I can shoot them, dead fast and over 1,000 experience. Nice. Oh, gotta crit them. I missed some shot crystals, didn't I? Oh, it doesn't. Oh, the beacon doesn't follow the crystals. Oh, that's so frustrating. Alright. Well. Here's the real question. Am I ready for these huge skags? I should keep going here. I know I should definitely get more ammo. Is there one more of those skags? There are. Can't get him in the crit zone. Well, not if he turns that way. Oh, shit, there's two of them. Three of. Oh crap. Nope, 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 nope. Screaming? Come on. Scream again. Nope, nope, nope. We'll come back for that. We'll come back to that later. So we'll head to the arid hills. Heading to the arid hills. I don't know where I am at. There I am. Alright. Thank you. go. Perfectly reasonable size skags. Except that one of them's a badass fire skag. I'm stuck. Well, that was unexpected.
Nothing like a challenging kill.
Whew. After those big nasty skags in the shock crystal caverns, I was kind of expecting to have more trouble with that big fancy fire skag, but I guess it worked out. Go.
I wonder what your fuck mine.
This guy's immune to fire. And I'm out of other weapons. Thank you, Bloodwing. A bloated rack. Has loot in its belly. Like at least a gun. Alright, carrying on. Need some health pickups. Should be careful when shooting at racks. I forget that they sometimes create big swarms, and they're not likely to let it go. Feel a little thirsty. That looks like a piece of the goal. Two pieces. Sure, teach me a lesson while you're on fire. Piece number three. Ooh, is that a shock weapon?
These can penetrate most shields and have a chance of stunning their target.
Nice. Not worth it. Complete. All right. Now we could go back and turn that in, but we're actually right where we want to be. Whoops. I'm getting all turned around because I'm exhausted. Okay. Here's the question. Do we go through the mine this episode, or do we wait till the next episode? Seems like a pretty short episode. No, you know what? I'm gonna go for a longer episode. I'm gonna take you through the mine now. The sledge house. I'm gonna take you through the sledge house now. But I do need to go get some water and stretch, so I will be right back. Alright, I'm back and with a cup of coffee, so I think I've got some stuff to sell. Should probably check over some of these guns. Static thumper. Looks like it does a lot less damage. Oh, its fire rate is only 2. Yeah, okay. Well, looks like I've equip the best things going, so sell the rest. Can't afford that. I think I want that healing shield, and I'm gonna get all healed up, or at least a little healed up. Oh, really a little healed up. Never mind. I can deal without... Yeah, I'll say that's better. Come on. The shield will heal me. I do need a storage tech upgrade. Or two. Somebody knows I'm here. None of those guys, though. So I admit, part of the reason that I want to do the safe house tonight rather than waiting till the next episode is I kind of just love this map. Hear the claptrap from here. I need to remember to reload before stepping into a room. Died yet. Oh, I'm gonna die like this. That's pathetic. First death. Stupid exploding barrel got me. And I was so hoping to be impressive too and not die for like at least until hitting sledge. I always seem to bite it here though because I forget about that barrel. Hey, Bernie. Where did you go? The heck are you? Oh, you're up there. So I wish that I had been able to do the shock harvest, shock crystal harvest, because there's a better example of the claptrap rescue in there. But I'll have to check that out. There's a claptrap behind this wall, which I can access. Yep, right there. And now I get to look for a repair kit. And in Borderlands 1, that was how you got storage deck upgrades for your backpack, so you can carry more stuff. Dang, man, it's dry in here. Probably gonna open the window and let some cold in, because I think the heater is drying everything out. Cold outside air isn't going to be any more moist than the heater air, but at least it'll be colder. Alright, hold on. Drink some coffee. Drink some water. And crack the window. I'm cooler already. My sinuses are just so dry, you know? Oh my god. What the hell's wrong with me? Now, because we picked up that toolkit, I can turn in the claptrap rescue and make sure to use this SDU and not sell it for 58 monies. Level 15 and I'm level 13? Alright. Alright. Check that out eventually. No full. Thank you. Okay, so you may have noticed by now that some of the names of some of the mobs are not particularly PC. I will say that I think Borderlands understands this now, because they've changed the name of the mutant short peoples to Tinks. They tend to be tinkerers. But, you know, it was a learning curve. Oh, this door here opens on the way back, and I have to remember that because this whole map is confusing to me on the way out. I get so turned around on the way out because it looks different, so. Fill up some ammo. Check out this here gun box.
So you want me to share, huh?
Secret hidden gun locks. Usually go the other way, so this time I'll go this way. I remember why I go this way. This way. There's ammo boxes here. All right. Take a swig of fortifying brew. And let's be off. Ring of severed thumbs.
You should be able to get into the mine now. There's nothing between you and Sledge, and we're one step closer to the vault. I believe in you.
Cool. Let's bump that skill point. And... now to figure out how to get back. Alright. Up here. Oh, that door is not the door that opens. That door is the door that opens. Transfusion grenade. Yes, thank you. Transfusion grenades are great because not only do they return you health, but they also home in on enemies and deal damage directly, so you don't have to aim. And aiming grenades is something that I am terrible at. Also, aiming in general seems to be something that I'm fairly terrible at. Look at that. Safe and sound. You know what? I'm good with both my shield and my grenade for now. And we're done here. And I think, actually, yeah, I'm gonna call that time. It's like almost an hour. Maybe we'll get back to... we'll get back to Shep, turn in quests, and then we'll call it a night. And, yeah, I'm just gonna run straight through. Wahoo!
Kill them all! Take a hike, asshole!
It's not very nice, guys. Stop at a box, but But what film would that be? Alright. Shep, you right here? Yeah, you are. Oh, I don't turn into you. Okay. Well. Firestone Bounty Board, then. What I like about later Borderlands are quality of life improvements. Like buying all of your ammo all at once without even having to go for the vending machine screen. Alright, so let's just get to where we're going for next time and then we'll call it a day. I keep getting turned around here. Has it really been that long since I've played this through? There we go.
Everything you've faced up until now has been simple. You're about to face a real challenge in Sledge. Do not underestimate him.
Cool. I hate you, Claptrap. Thanks. Alright, so, I am going to... I'm going to call it here. And when we return, tomorrow, I will be right ready here to enter the Headstone Mine, but I'm going to go and pick up those other quests from Shep and the Bounty Board. Because I should have gotten them already. So, yeah, we're going to call it, and thanks everybody for joining me.